afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is June 27th. It is Fitness Friday. But first, before we get into Fitness Friday, I just took an awesome run, and I just want to kind of give you a real-world example. Anne-Marie got into a little fender bender yesterday. She's okay. And I don't have a car today, so I can't drive to the normal park that I usually do my running at. So today I went down the hill here, and there's a little park that I don't really necessarily care too much about, but it's a little park. I did some laps there, and I did some circuit training. So I did some push-ups, I did some pull-ups, and I did a few other exercises while I was doing my run, came back up the hill, and took me about 45 minutes, and it was just awesome. It was great. I jumped in the shower, and I just got out of the shower. We got friends coming, so I need to finish this show. But just an example of that, an example of a circuit like that is something that you can find or you can use to be able to, you know, cut to the chase when you have like 30 minutes, get out there, do it, come back, and then you can go and do the things you want to do. Again, you don't need to have to go to the gym and take, you know, 3 hours. It used to take me like 3 hours because I used to drive to the gym. I used to work out at the gym, talk to people there at the gym. Then I used to drive home, and then I needed to shower. It usually took about 3 hours every time I went to the gym. Now we just have our stuff here. We have a couple weights, and we take care of it here. And now I do a little circuit. So that's the benefit of circuit training. You can get your strength training and your cardiovascular training done in one fell swoop. Yesterday, Lisa asked a question on the blog about cod liver oil. And if cod liver oil, if you should be concerned about heavy metals. Absolutely you should be concerned about heavy metals in cod liver oil. The bigger the fish, the more likely they're gonna have more heavy metal toxicity because they eat the smaller fish and the smaller fish eat all the other things. And that what happens is up the food chain, the heavy metal toxicity increases. So you do need to be careful about that. The cod liver oil that we use is called Sones, S-O-N-N-E-S. And I don't know why it says number 5, but Sones number 5. And they actually test. You're going to want to check on your cod liver oil is, you know, to ensure that they test to ensure the product is free from heavy metals and pesticides. So you want to make sure that they're testing for those. You don't want to get cheap cod liver oil because what they do is they sell this stuff literally in 55-gallon barrels at auction. And then, you know, if you're buying it from Costco or you're buying it from even from some of the like GNC brands, like the lower end, cheaper brands, you're going to be getting rancid cod liver oil. And I don't, if anything, there's nothing I don't think that sounds more disgusting than rancid cod liver oil. I mean, can you think of anything? It's gross. So this is why I recommend krill oil. Because see, the difference between cod and krill, probably even smaller than that, is that the krill, their lifespan is anywhere from 6 months to 6 years, depending on the species. So they're real tiny guys, and they don't live long, and they don't have time to build up that heavy metal toxicity. So that's why krill oil is so good. You can still get the long-chain omega-3 oils, but you don't have to worry about all the massive omega-3. No, not the omega-3. You get all the omega-3 oils. You don't have to worry about all the heavy metal toxicity. So that's really important. I'm so glad you asked that question, Lisa, because I didn't cover it yesterday. And I was going to do it for another show, but I might as well do it today. So if you have any other questions about that, go ahead and post down below. But let's get into today's workout. Today's workout is not as sexy as you know, getting firm abs or toning up your butt or working on the flab on the underarms, because there's a reason for it. One of our clients asked a question about how she can get her wrists stronger, because what happens is when she does some of these exercises, her wrists hurt. Well, what a great question. It's almost like, you know, before you become a, you know, a politician, well, you know, a national politician, you have to go through some of the local ranks, right? I mean, you've got to be like the mayor or something before you can be, you know, president. So here's the deal. You've got to strengthen your wrists before you can do some of the inverted poses in yoga, before you can do some push-ups, before you can do pull-ups. And I know that there's a lot of women out there, guys that you're watching, that say, hey, you know, I'd love to do some of this stuff, but my wrists, they hurt like heck. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you three exercises that you can do to strengthen your wrist while you're sitting at your desk. All right, here we go, man. I am sweating. It is so hot. And I just took a shower, but I'm probably going to have to take another one because it is so hot here. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to show you three exercises for your wrist. This here is just a barbell that doesn't have any weight on it. And it's probably going to be best for some, you know, the women out there who are watching, because this thing is about 2.5 pounds. And it's probably going to be as much as you want to use when you start. For guys, you can put some weight on this and really, you know, jack it up if you want. And it's going to allow you to be able to do some more inverted stuff or be able to use the pull-up bar or something like that. But the first exercise that you're going to do, all you're going to do is you're going to take this little bar, you're going to grasp it, and then you're just going to almost, it's a wrist curl, that's what it's called. And you're just going to curl up your wrists just like this. And this is going to build strength in your forearm. You'll see a lot of bodybuilders, they'll put a ton of weight on here and they'll really build up the strength in their forearms. Second exercise, you're just going to flip your grip, and then you're just going to pull up here. This is going to be really good for those of you who have trouble doing push-ups or have trouble walking out on the exercise ball here. This is really going to help with that feeling that you get right in the back of your wrist here, you know, that straining or that sharp pinch. This is going to help strengthen that up, just like this. The third exercise is so simple. You can do this with a stress ball, or you can do it the way I'm going to suggest to do it. Whatever you want to do is up to you. It's fine. But you can use a stress ball, and you can just squeeze. That'll strengthen up your forearm and your wrist. Or what you can do is this, and I love this exercise. One of my friends in high school track taught me this exercise. All you do is this. It's for your grip. What you're going to do is you're just going to open and close your hands as fast as you can for as long as you can. I guarantee you, in 30 seconds to a minute, you are going to be burning, and you're going to be going about as fast as this. But this is all you have to do. This is really going to strengthen your wrist. It's really going to get you the strength and the ability to be able to do the exercises that you may not be able to do now because your wrists are weak. So your question of the day is this. Next week, Mike Adams and I are coming out with a massive, massive, massive project. It's going to change the way that you get your health information online and eventually offline. So sounds pretty exciting, right? Well, here's the question of the day. I want you to guess what it is. That's all. I know that some of you might know what it is. So those of you who might know what it is, you can't guess. But for those of you who don't know what it is, I want you to guess and go ahead and post it down below. And the first person who gets it right, we're going to send them a free copy of our book. So that's your question of the day. Go ahead and post it down below. I'm off to edit this video and greet our friends when they come and maybe take another shower because, man, it is so hot here. And together we can change the health of the world one show at a time. Have a great weekend and stay tuned for next week.